We are the divided states of America. In moments when we have been tested as a nation again and again in recent years, whether it be COVID-19 or gun violence that takes so many from us every year, when it truly matters that we come together not as Democrats or Republicans, but as human beings and Americans united to protect our country, we have failed systematically and across the board. And I don't blame the American people. I blame our elected officials that have failed at their most important job, which is to help unite the people, especially in moments of crisis, and to act, not to debate, not to say Democrats are the issue or Republicans are the issue, but to say that the issue in this case is gun violence. But they don't want to, and I'll tell you why. Because they like to be comfortable. They want us to believe that the issue is other day, you know, everyday Americans that have different political views than us, when in reality, the real issue are the people with power that choose to do nothing, even though they have it. If we are going to solve gun violence, it is on us as a people to become the United States of America. Not only united against gun violence, but united against the injustice and violence that drives it. United against the poverty and systemic racism that was purpose-built into this country, that is united for our children and for our future, where when we're signing laws, we're not thinking about whether or not we're going to lose an election. We're thinking about whether or not this is actually going to help protect the future of our children and the future of our country, because in reality, that is what really matters. That focus on the future of our country and the protection of our children should be at the core of all of our political decisions. But it's not, but it can be. And the first step to doing that is Republicans coming forward and conservative Democrats coming forward and taking a stand for something and realizing there is 1,000 times more honor in actually being a leader and understanding that leaders have to do courageous things, sometimes things that may cost them their careers, but ultimately is the right thing. Because I'll tell you what, if what you're concerned about is your legacy and how you'll look in the history books, the answer is it's going to be written by people like me and other young people. We're going to write the history books about you. You get to decide what your legacy is. It can be one of division and destruction and the beginning of the end, or the beginning of a new beginning, where the United States is truly actually united against injustice and progresses towards building what Dr. King talked about and building the beloved community, because that can be your legacy. What we need to do is work across the aisle, because the reality is none of this is ever going to happen with a filibuster in its current form. And until that changes or doesn't change, reality is people are going to continue dying and we don't have time to wait. So we need to work across the aisle and make something happen. We need to show our elected officials that we are more than just the filibuster, that as a country, we actually are united to address gun violence and the preventable deaths that sadly happen way too often in the United States. But the way that we do that is by stopping the division that they use to, you know, stay comfortable, and after these instances, divide us against each other, turn us into talking points on TV, and then move on afterwards and just have their same talking points of thoughts and prayers that they've had for decades. Because we can't end this issue, but we have to show our elected officials that we as the American people are united. So let's work together and end this.